babies, toddlers, and teens. Brace yourselves, people, the kids are taking over. It's You've Been Framed, the next generation. Welcome to the show. I do like this Pitbull Terrier game. All the excitement and social standing of owning a Pitbull Terrier, but without the tiresome interference of social services. Spot the wet wipe, everyone. There it is. Sometimes I like to play Spot the Wet Wipe when I'm not playing Pitbull Terrier the game. And here we are at summer camp. There are thousands of these across America with names like Camp Confidence and Camp Athletic. All there to develop different skills and talents. This one is called Camp Diving, and it literally teaches children how to dive in a camp way. This boy isn't taking the plunge. They need to send in the instructor.
Go.
That's 5 on the camp scoreboard.
Can we take a risk, Skyler?
No.
Well, Daddy's not going to show you where he is.
Can anyone spot Tigger?
I don't know where he is.
Tigger, anyone?
He's hiding on you.
Where's Tigger gone?
Tigger be in the kitchen?
I owe him there.
You did? Did you look in your bedroom?
Not yet.
Did you look outside? Maybe you left him outside.
Yeah.
Mom and Dad aren't going to help you find him, though. Go look for you.
I need to try. Oh, I have.
With investigative skills like that, he could be a future commander of the Met. Now, see if you can find that wet wipe. This little fella does an impression of a velociraptor when he's surprised. Book him for primeval, someone. That's either Artex on the wall or they've got a very big cat. These small cars are all very well, but they're prone to rust, and before you know it, you've got no floor. Yazoo now. And it was always a slightly odd relationship between Vince Clark and Alison Moyet. Ooh, sorry. And if it isn't North Korean dictator and missile tester, Kim Jong-il, being pampered once again by one of his many servants. It's this servant's job to teach him English, a task she seems to be performing excellently.
Hello.
Say hello.
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 Is she blowing or sucking? Show her how it's done. She's got one there that she's done earlier. Practice makes perfect. The love between brothers and sisters now. And look at the shine on that floor. Someone's going to get red knees. That's it. Hotwire it. New plates. And turn the clock back. It'll be in Rio by the weekend and no one's the wiser. Anyone who dresses their kids up like a Victorian bather needs a reality check, in my view. Poor kid. And it's a long walk back to the bathing machine. Important product recall notice. If you've bought a yellow peddler bike recently, please return it to the shop. It has a small structural fault that's barely noticeable but needs attention. For my money, that trampet is a little too close to the swing.
Don't kick her.
Don't give her ideas, Mum.
I'm not
standing too close.
Mary, I mean it.
Come on, Mary.
It's our own fault for standing too close. So...
Yes, there is a certain rough justice to the outcome on this clip. A Lollipop, the opening song of the now-forgotten Kojak the Musical. Of course, the lollipop was his trademark. Lollipop, he would say, sucking on a... well, a lollipop. It was magic. So where's her lollipop? Well, it took a hell of a lot of licking, but she ate it. Imagine the size of the bag of sherbet you need to dib-dab that in. A very impressive hula hoop work there. But even more impressive is the fact her little brother has based his hairstyle on Phil Collins's. If you've seen the Joy Division documentary, you'll recognise this dance routine as classic Ian Curtis. Love, love will tear us apart again. Love, everybody, love will tear us apart again. Apart again. All right, don't milk it. In every performance, you should always leave your public with a big finish. And there it is. I'll finish it off for you. You. What the devil is that? So imagine all the girls and the screams. Now, blimey, look at all that lovely wood. They'll be warm this winter. But here's a youngster filming himself doing his skater stunts, no doubt to play it back and analyse how he can improve it. Analyse away, pal. The only other witness, the dehumidifier. Series 20 of I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here, and the money's run out. Here's X Factor hopeful Eoghan Quigg on a cut-price bush tucker challenge. He's got to fetch a ball from a duck pond in Swaffham. Pack your bags. You're going home. Look at the tiny traffic cones. What a lovely surprise. This bunch have spent the money on the track. Because look at the hurdle. Oh, they've gone off-road. What does young Romeo Beckham get up to when his mum and dad are out on one of their nights out?
Strike one.
Oops! No, I can't see where it went either. But let's hope it's not Dad's trophy cabinet.
Okay, Toby, to make it in the NFL, you gotta be mean. You gotta be tough. You gotta be fearless. No pain.
No pain.
No pain.
No pain.
No pain.
Remind me, what was it? No what? In London, people would pay 400 grand just for a shower cubicle, as long as they can fit into it.
She thinks she's so flexible. Damn, she broke in half, son. Latest try.
Still, it's handy for the city. I think we all remember the episode of Neighbours when the first skateboard reached Erinsborough. Have another go. Have another go. Have another go. Have another. Actually, that's enough. Still to come, brotherly love.
Yes.
Oh, the caring parent. And the flatulent goat. All on You've Been Framed, the next generation. Welcome back to You've Been Framed, The Next Generation. Where's this taking place? Some sort of enclosure? But one of them is markedly heavier than the other.
Daniel's.
I think it's Daniel. Quite a crowd has gathered to watch the young daredevil. Three girls and two bushes. And he's good. Not once, but twice. Oh, show's over. Global warming really has increased the water table, hasn't it? Here's the 2:45 train from Swaffham. We really need to get someone down there with a mop and bucket. Now, when this cameraman is very excited, he becomes a strange mix of man and pigeon. Plu plu, plu plu. Go build your nest. Here's movie star Brad Pitt in his Benjamin Button makeup having a strop in his trailer. Brad's PA is his grandmother. She really suffers for her $800 per year.
But if you hit Grandma with the airplane, then we can't play with him anymore because that's naughty.
He used to be so easygoing, and now this.
A wonderful plane!
This was not a happy set to be on. He's talking about his private jet, obviously.
It's hard to be a little boy, but you have to be nice. You cannot.
But the movie company put up with all this. He's a bankable name. What can they do? I think her days are numbered. The thing is, Brad, you're standing there in your pants, and frankly, you look ridiculous.
It's not stupid, it's just the way that it works.
He hasn't been the same since he married Angelina.
Don't get blind, you blind, really.
Did you know?
For years after losing on Fame Academy, Lamar would teach his fans how to destroy a stylized effigy of Cat Deeley. But this bitterness only led to more hurt. And eventually Lamar was able to break the cycle of regret and move on. Punishment at this school is high tech. These children are on the clip round the ear machine. Time for another Ofsted report, I think. John Barrowman's wet room wasn't designed to afford him much privacy, was it? That hedge isn't going to stop anyone looking. And poor Harvey from E17 still hasn't worked out the controls. This film is actually filmed by a computer. There's the keyboard there in front of shot. It spent the 250 quid on a new mouse. I love the baubles on top of the trampoline posts. Gives it a vaguely regal feel, doesn't it? Escape from trampoline enclosure times two.
Are you okay?
How did Wayne Rooney end up looking the way he does? Like that! Sorry, Wayne. Love you, really. Where does Orba the Greek stay on his holidays? Why, Hotel Yorba. I've been thinking of a little place down that way. They got a dirty old road leading up to the house. I wonder how long it will take till we're alone. Sitting on the front porch of that home. Stomping our feet on the wooden floor. Never got to worry about locking the door. One, two, three, four, take the elevator at the Hotel Yorba. I'll be glad to see you later. Parenting. The ZZ Top guys are great fun to have around. Kids love them, and they really go for it. Well worth the 20 quid fee. And Peter Mandelson now. Not so good with the kids. And four times the price. Never book Jo Brand for a kid's party. She refuses to take her shoes off on the bouncy castle. Oh, Jo. Fathers for Justice with a sponsored swing-in. And if you're not used to it, you can go in a bit strong. Oh, you pushed him a bit hard, Dad. Which one was Spider-Man? I bet that took a long time to blow up. But without any form of skeleton, it is unable to support itself. That's the advantage we have over the invertebrates. How does the old song go? Happy... How old are you now? I think the GP might need to reduce the HRT there. Only Fools and Horses star Nicholas Lyndhurst entertained the neighbour's children. You plonker, Rodney.
Go, Daly.
Go, Daly. Well, it's usually more than once a day. Oh, I see. That's his name. Apologies.
Push, Daly, push.
Look out! He's got a gun! This Christmas, why not teach your kids how to fight? Fighting. It's the new arguing. By 2 a.m, the family were beginning to think that the all-you-can-eat trip to the sweet factory was, in retrospect, a bad idea. David Beckham takes a few moments out from his busy schedule of pants modelling to show off to his son. And if you're wondering how he gets that ball to do that, he's got a hamster inside it. Yeah, not great for young Romeo. Or the hamster.
Help! I can't breathe! I'm in a ball!
And that's the hamster speaking. It's the Chelsea Junior training camp. In basic training, players ride bikes to learn the correct way to dive in the box. Here we go. Slight tap, over, penalty awarded. Textbook, whatever that means. It's a little known fact that nightclub podium dancers have the hardest training regime of any job. He's failed. It's not actually that crazy, is it, Crazy Golf? Someone ought to redesign it for the modern day thrill seeker. Steeper, windier. Keep the windmill, though. That's the best bit. Just in case you missed it. I felt that. Ooh. When he's not eating chocolate, the Milky Bar Kid is to be found practicing his stunt work.
Alfie, you'll pull that and you'll fall straight out.
Listen to your dad. He put his finger on the one weakness of your plan, didn't he? It was low budget, but Neil Diamond, the early years, had a certain appeal. There's Neil as a three-year-old, with a little help from his friend. Bombed at the box office. Leave your kids alone for long enough and they'll come up with a new game. I want to go. I want to go. By the way, the light streaming through the front door, I'd say their front garden must be an absolute sun trap. It's the Billy Elliot story all over again. He loves to boogie, but he's not quite ready for the Royal Ballet. There's a minor in the making if ever I saw one. Right, then off you go. It's so bad his guitar's attacked him.
I don't like it. Get off. I don't like that. Stop it.
There's certainly some cash in that attic. Yes, if I was his parents, I'd be worried about him. That tie's too long for a start. Five brass buttons on his jacket. Add to that the frantic balancing act. He needs a paper round.
Set up place here.
Well, what do you do if you've locked yourself out and Mum doesn't get back from her shift for another hour? How ingenious is man? He's got just the right attitude to be a rock drummer. And a great finish. A poke in the eye. Lovely. If he's not careful, he's going to end up with one leg bigger than the other. Oh, well, never mind.
Let's go home.
Yeah, let's go home.
Let's head outdoors. Here's a quick and easy way to learn how to do Irish dancing. All you need is a mouse in a bucket. River dance! This was the prototype for London's Millennium Bridge. It was just a bit too wobbly to start with. They may have carried Jesus into Jerusalem, but they still get colds. Give him a Strepsil. Rope swings now. Along with trampolines, they are the bread and butter of You've Been Framed. But the bread is mouldy and the butter is sour. I think he's stopped enjoying it, Dad. Oh, it was only an inch deep. Big fret. And the best ramp consists of 12 different items. It improves its stability.
Hey, you don't want to do that.
What would Charlie Chaplin be doing if he was making films now on a phone? Something like that, I suppose. Mary Pickford likes it. Spot the odd one out. That's right. It's the girl's second from the right on the mushroom. Are those garden chairs any more reliable in green? No. You get what you pay for. Never get too close to the rear end of a goat. He did warn you. He rang his bell. You may well look sheepish. Well, goaty. Try placing this accent.
Hey, bird big boy, look at your balloon.
Cornwall, or is it Canadian? Oh, he's away. Keep your eye on the ball. Yeah, that's it. Not both eyes. You'll hit the wall. All filmed by a chicken. The entire outer surface of this apparently harmless toy is electrified up to 8,000 volts. This effectively clears a safe path for the child, no matter what he might run into. Just ask the cat.
What I do?
Now, at some point in this charming clip, it will stop being fun for this little boy.
Okay,
so I've enlisted the help of an American lady whose job it is to tell us exactly when it stopped being fun.
Okay, stop being fun, it stopped being fun.
Actually, I thought it stopped being fun just a little bit before that. Oh, I love Freeview. All sorts of channels you wouldn't normally watch, like Channel 5, for instance. Wall-to-wall infotainment. Here we go, then. Everybody, 1, 2, 3... The wheels on the bus go in all directions, actually. Actually, that's not a bus, it's a fire engine. Still, you get the idea. Good parenting ain't easy, and even the kids know when it's not going right. Teach me something, Dad. I want to learn. Kids, over to you. Throw some shapes.
I wanna see, come on baby, let me tell ya all the things I wanna see, and everybody.
Before the break, I asked the question, are you a crybaby?
Maybe.
In other words, will there be tears before bedtime? See what you think. Back soon! Welcome back. So, were there tears as she gets her jabs? No, she loves pain. She hasn't even got a holiday planned. And she's fully up to date with her BCG. Poor girl, she hasn't got a boy to dance with, so she has to make do with an office chair. And even that's chucked her. If you're new to it, the mock Tudor home of Victoria Beckham in Basildon can be difficult to find your way around, particularly at night and after a few drinks. Party time! What's your favourite letter? Hers is F. Flaming candles won't blow out. Forget it, I can't be bothered. It's the energy-saving cheerleaders, touring the country and coming down hard on anyone who hasn't fitted energy-efficient bulbs. The energy-saving cheerleaders, dancing in your carbon footprint soon. Sometimes politeness is not enough. That happens at the Royal Ballet more often than you think. Darcy Bustle is known to trump like a trooper. Someone open the window.
Come on, Ben.
She loves that tent, doesn't she?
She does love that tent. And who can blame her? Every time she comes out, this happens. Get back in that tent. Message for you.
I can see the silhouettes dancing up against the wall. Sure feels good, feels good. Yeah, we're gonna lose control. Turn it on, make it strong. Good thing, kicking up the dust and making every move we know.
Funny walk, yes, but she's actually doing Chinese writing with her feet. And all that's required at the end is a full stop. Open brackets, close brackets.
Careful!
Full stop. Question mark. Oh, Chinese foot writing. Great fun.
Are you going to put the vinegar in? Can it explode?
Ah, yes, he'd tap a kegger. I've got all his records. He shouldn't be in charge of a kid, in my view. Babysitters, eh? Ever wondered why Bob Carroll G's decided to call it a day at one child?
What?
Oh, I felt that. And once again, oh, right on the epididymis. It's a source of considerable shame to David Beckham that his kids aren't actually that good at football. Even hiring Ronaldo during school holidays to coach them proved to be a waste of money. Brooklyn can't even do a decent header. Oh. Hopeless. Hopeless! If you've captured a memorable moment on your mobile, you can upload it directly to us at itv.com/framed. It couldn't be easier getting your hands on 250 quid if your phone clip is used in one of our programmes. Sporty kids now. You've heard of the header, haven't you? Well, here's the facer. That's it. Keep it in play. They recently had a new fence put round this park. 20 feet too close to the pitch. They do say you're never too young to start boxing training. Keeps them out of trouble, doesn't it? I mean, it worked for the Cray brothers. Well, you know. I mean, they were always nice to their mums and they never ever done no one that wasn't also a geezer. And the winner of today's best sharp intake of breath goes to... Mum! It's the golf squash hybrid that Deborah Meaden backed to the hilt on Dragon's Den. Yet to see a return on her investment. Oh, look at the lovely lavender. There's some more, look. Bee's paradise, that garden. Another 3 years, and she should be ready for 2012.
We got about 2 minutes worth of life left in it, so we better get this one. Oh.
Yeah, but you won't always have the roof to bounce it off, will you? Go on, Emma. Okay. Next time, try the same thing a little to your left, love. A punch bag conveniently slung under the stairs. Nice idea.
Yeah, I'm fine. I planned that all along.
I don't know the rules, but it's a bit like rounders with padding. Shouldn't he be wearing some sort of helmet? Or a suit of armour? Someone went a bit mad with the conifers, didn't they? He planted a conifer every time he took the car out to reduce his carbon footprint. But he is good, that Aled Jones. Snowman! Meanwhile, at the Billy Elliot halfway house, it gets them ready to go back into the outside world. Uh-oh, an escape attempt. Poor Sir Elton. It's Christmas at Vernon Kay's house, and Grandad's losing on the wee tennis.
It was an accident, honest. Yeah, right.
That's me, ready?
Hey, you ready?
The pygmy. Not normally an aggressive race, yet when an outsider eggs them on, they will fight until one of them is hurt.
Hold it.
But so ashamed of this lapse in tribal code, they turn their aggression toward the outsider. Either that or it's two South American kids having a bit of a fight in their front room. We just show the clips. We don't get told the background. Do other delivery companies promise your parcel will reach its exact destination? Do they promise your parcel will arrive intact and undamaged? Do they promise a tracking system so you know where the parcel is at any time? The answer to all these questions is yes. Yes. All the other delivery companies make those promises. But do they promise your parcel will have legs to actually walk inside your house to the room of your choosing? No, they don't. Only framed parcels offer you this. Scientists prove listening to Iron Maiden whilst still in the womb has adverse effects later in life. There are similar effects with children who listen to AC/DC, Judas Priest, and same difference. That's from our science correspondent, Lawrence McGinty. The way that space shuttle is pointing, that little boy is going to get it in the nose. Unless there's a sudden change of direction. It could happen. English lessons for Junior. Say hi.
Say hi.
Hi.
Say how are you?
How are you?
Say sorry. Ah, the old dandelion clock. What is the time?
6:00.
1:00.
One more.
2:00.
Good.
I've got 5:40. I must get this watch fixed. Ah, the lure of the stickleback. They're like a drug to a 5-year-old. They exert a powerful hold.
Wave at the camera.
Stickleback!
Dad's homemade Dalek costume was a bit poor, but it was cheap. Where is the doctor? Where is... Where is the doctor? No, really.
I banged my chin.
Oh, dear.
Time for a jump.
I wish I'd never given this lad that farm job. Oi, the pigs need mucking out. Yep, that's how it should be done. Pretty impressive, I think you'll agree. And here's the apprentice. Has that child got enough soft toys, I ask myself. Riding on a soft toy, clutching a soft toy with two soft toys on his feet as another soft toy looks on. Soft toys, hard landing. Music now, and the fickle mistress that is love. Disappearing acts. Storage solutions. And some sweet dreams. All on You've Been Framed, the Next Generation. Welcome back to the final installment of You've Been Framed, the Next Generation. He's been pulled over for driving erratically. Have you been drinking, sir? I'm afraid I'll have to ask you to accompany me to the station. Just come with me, sir. We'll take down your particulars.
Come on, honey. Can we get out of the car?
All right, put him back. as long as he promises to use the back routes home.
Okay, one more ride.
Dear, oh dear, I've gone soft in my old age. Answer it then. Might be important. Might be Noel Edmonds.
Wow. Oh. Is that good?
And now for a few impressions. Ken Dodd. How tickled I am. Bugs Bunny.
What's up, Doc?
Roland Rat.
Kevin, Rat fans.
Right. Here's the organic baby food. No, he doesn't want that.
Watch this.
And here's the... Uh-oh. Don't tell Jamie Oliver, will you? We'll do another show about it. This little baby, sadly, is born with slow-motion disease. Yes, everything he does is in slow motion. Except the screams. Uh-oh. Someone's going to get a black eye. Oh. Told you. Where's his arm gone? Oh, there he is. Phew. Bullseye! Some of that Body Shop stuff smells so good you don't know whether to eat it or put it on your face. Careful, Mum. You're just making it worse. Ah, it stings. It stings. It's true, children can clutter up your living room. That's why you need the automatic framed child tidy. Job done. Kids and toys are a potent mix.
Game on the table.
Duncan Ballantyne has not been generous this year.
It's a more modern version of a yo-yo.
A yo-yo, great.
Oh, I think it is. Yeah.
I'll do this.
Yeah, well, don't do so.
And for that reason, I'm afraid I'm out. Oddly, in some young offenders' units, you're allowed one toy. He chose the space hopper. At some point, something's got to go wrong for this little fella.
You're going to hit yourself in the face.
Yeah, it could be that. You've seen this clip before, haven't you? At Charlotte Church's Swansea home, they spent a fortune on this track to get her through a driving test. And now it's little Dexter's turn.
Slow.
Chip off the old block.
Get him quick. Quick.
One question. Why the swimming trunks? Since the film work dried up, R2-D2 has been forced to keep himself in oil by performing home dentistry. And they've got the nerve to knock our NHS.
Way to go, R2! Way to go!
Let me see you, Trev.
Yeah.
Smile. Smile. Oh, much better.
The youngest status quo fan in the world here, but he's watched them closely and learnt their methods. Yes, it does need a little adjustment, Dad, doesn't it? Even Parfit didn't go that far.
Okay, I'm going. I'm sorry. I'll knock next time. Okay. I'm going. What you got in your pants?
Mind your own business. They look like a fun family, don't they? Just pray they don't move in next door to you. And after all that excitement, relax. You've earned it.
To dream, impossible dreams. To fight the unbeatable foe. To bear with unbearable sorrow. To run where the brave dare not go. This is my quest. To follow that star, no matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right, without question or pause, to be willing to.
Frame fans, don't forget to keep sending your tapes and DVDs to Free Post You've Been Framed, or just go to itv.com/frame, where you can upload your clips direct. Now it's even easier getting your hands on 250 quid if your clip is used in one of our programs. And don't forget to check out our website for terms and conditions. Until next time, cheerio!
Next over on our new channel ITVB, it's dating meets food head-on in Dinner Date. Get these numbers favourited now. And over on ITV at 8 o'clock, you know what it is. I don't even need to say it really, do I? It's the X Factor live. Right after that, back here on ITV2, we have our say with the Extra Factor. Next now, though, family fun with Valentine.